Heat maps are useless in NBA Infinite, is what I would say if I keep missing a wide open, perfectly timed on the hot zone 3. I ended up missing so many shots in my hot zone, which got me thinking, does shooting on your heat map even matter in NBA Infinite? If you're not sure what a heat map is, it's special zones on the court that can boost your shot success rate. We'll call the areas with no heat map the neutral zone, yellow zones are standard, and red zones are hot zone. To figure if heat maps really work, I used a tool on my phone to record my shot timing for consistency. For this testing, I went with a ranked 4 Kyrie Irving. I went into training mode, turned on heat maps, and took 200 shots in each zone. After shooting and rebounding, I finished my first test. Here are the results. On neutral, I got 41%. On standard, I got 42%. And in the hot zone, I got 48.5%. At a first glance, you'd be like, wow, it does increase your shooting percentage. But I wanted to test again to see if it's guaranteed to give you more made shots. So I tested 200 shots again from each zone with R4 Irving. This time, the results look interesting. While I did end up getting pretty much the same percentage on the neutral zone from test number 1, the standard and hot zone's values were close in field goal percentage, but we still got an increase nonetheless. So does that mean you can go either on standard or hot zones and it wouldn't matter? Well, at the time that I was testing all of this, the Prime Collection for Stephen Curry came out, and I wouldn't pass up to get the greatest shooter of all time on my roster, so I got him and did this exact same test. This is an R3 Steph Curry, and here are the results that came back. Although the shots we took are all wide open and mostly on the blue part of the meter, it's crazy to me that he shoots above 60% from 3 in this game consistently. The field goal percentage might tell you that shooting in standard and hot zones won't matter much, but I looked back on all the tests and found something interesting. I looked at how many shots players made in a row and how many shots they missed in a row. More often than not, you're more likely to go on a longer shooting streak when on standard zones compared to neutral zones, and you can even go on a crazy shooting streak on hot zones with Steph hitting 15 in a row. That's crazy. But as you'll see in test 2, you won't really get those results all the time. Looking at the missed streaks, shooting on your heat map won't really make you miss less shots. So what does it really mean? Are standard and hot zones useless? Well, yes and no. Let me explain. Your shooting percentage is mainly dictated by your shooting stat, how open you are, and your shot timing. Using the heat map can improve your field goal percentage. It says so in the game itself. Can, not will. This basically means it's a chance within a chance and doesn't mean that it's worthless, but if you have the chance to shoot on it, I'd recommend you to do so. What will matter is you being open, getting good shot release timing, and your player's shooting stat. Personally, I'm gonna keep shooting on my standard and hot zones by getting into my spots creatively, but in clutch situations, I'm just gonna take the best shot possible, whether that's in my hot zone or not. Do you feel like heat maps work for you? Let me know down in the comments below. If you don't know how to shoot, I got just the perfect video for you.